So we're going to start. So you all have your handout. So what's the topic that we're dealing with today?
You're not too young.
You're not too young. Yeah, you're not too young. That is today's topic. So in the Bible, there was a man called Timothy. So Timothy was a pastor, but most of the members in his church are older, much older than him. So I think he was a bit, he felt intimidated because they were much older than him. So his mentor, a man called Paul, told Timothy that don't be intimidated because your members are older than you. Don't let them look down at you because you are young. You are still the pastor of the church. When you are preaching, preach with boldness to the people. But Paul told him he still needs to be respectful. So if any elderly person in the church misbehaves, he should speak to the person as you will speak to your mom, or as you will speak to your dad, as you will speak to your brother, as you will speak to your sister. Don't be disrespectful because you are the pastor, especially if they are older than you. You will see nowadays, there are some young pastors who are very, very rude. People who are old enough to be their dad will be kneeling down in front of them. And this young pastor will be disrespectful, telling them or speaking to them rudely because they are the pastor. It is very wrong. Even if you are the pastor, you should still give respect to people who are older than you. So Paul told Timothy, you are the pastor, be bold. Speak, preach the word. Jesus is with you. Don't let them intimidate you. Don't let them tell you, go and sit down, you're a little boy. Don't let them do that, but be respectful to them when you are telling them off because they did something wrong. Speak to them as a mother, as a father. And if they are your age mates, speak to them as a brother, as a sister. But you are not too young to be the pastor. Paul did not say, okay, you are too young, go and sit down, let me put an older person there. No, God can choose anybody. You are not too young for God to use. If God wants to use you, God is not going to look at your age and say, this person is too young. God can use anybody. So let's look at our handouts. Who is the first example there?
David.
David. So let's read that Numbers 1:3. What does it say?
You must
count all the men of Israel, 20 years old or older. They will serve in the army of Israel. Yeah? So if you know the story of David, there was a war. And you know Goliath was threatening the Israelites and nobody could fight with Goliath. Why couldn't they fight with Goliath? Yeah.
He was
a giant and everybody was afraid of him. But David was not in that army. His brothers were. You remember? So why was David not part of those in the army? Yeah.
He was too young
because you see the Bible says that those who will go to war must be 20 years or older, which means David was not 20. He must have been younger than 20. If he was 20 or older, he also would have been in that war. You understand? So let's read the second verse. 1 Samuel 17:33. What does it say? Saul answered, you can't go out against this Philistine and fight him. You're only a boy. Goliath has been a warrior since he was a young man. So you see, David wanted to go and fight Goliath, but King Saul said, you can't because you are a young boy. But what happened in the end?
He
beat Goliath, even though he was a little boy. He was not a fighter. He was not a warrior. He was not old enough to be in the army. But he beat Goliath because God used David. God wanted to prove that you are not too young. I can use anybody. God can use anybody. So don't let anybody tell you, go and sit down. You are only a child. If you see anything wrong in society, you can speak out. You can speak to a grown-up about it. You can speak to your teacher about it. I say, this is wrong. And something will be done about it. Don't let anybody shut you up and say you are too young. David fought and won against Goliath, even though he was less than 20 years old. Turn your handouts over. And let's see the next person. The little maid. You know the story of the little maid?
No.
In Israel, because God allowed the people to be captured and taken away into other lands, especially Babylon, there was a little girl that was taken away from her family. So that little girl was taken into exile, yeah, as a slave. So she became a maid to a woman. That woman's husband is called Naaman. Naaman had a skin disease. He was a leper. Yeah, he had a skin disease. This little girl told her madam, you know, the woman, Naaman's wife, if only your husband can go to Israel, my country, we have a prophet there. This girl will be maybe 12 years old. There is a prophet there. He is very, very powerful. If your husband can go to him, he will cure his skin disease, his leprosy. And so somebody went to tell Naaman. This is what that little girl said. So let's read the verse. 2 Kings 5, 2 to 3 in your handout. Let's read together. The Arameans had gone out to steal from the Israelites, and they had taken a little girl as a captive from Israel. This little girl served Naaman's wife. She said to her mistress, I wish that my master would meet the prophet who lives in Samaria. He would heal Naaman of the disease. She's a little girl. She's in a foreign country. She can't see her mom or her dad again, but she remembers the God of Israel. She remembers that in her country, there is a prophet whom God uses. And she told her mistress, if only our master, your husband, can go there, that prophet will heal him. And they listened to her. She's a little girl. She's probably like Michelle. She didn't keep quiet. She knows the God whom she serves, which means even as a little girl, when she was back in Israel with her family, she used to serve God. She knows about prophet, that prophet. She told the man, and he went there, and he was healed. You see, just this little girl, God used her, and the man was healed, and he said, wow, there is a God in Israel. Our gods cannot do this, because every nation, they have their own gods. And he said, wow, you understand? That little girl, God used her. She didn't keep quiet. So you see somebody is going through something, you can tell them, you know, if only you can pray to God, he will answer your prayer. He will do this, he will do that. Don't be shy to tell people about your God. Now let's look at the next story. Who is it?
The Virgin Mary.
The Virgin Mary. So how old was Mary, do you think? Yeah.
15.
A bit younger. Huh?
12.
Yeah, between 12 and 15. Between 12 and 15, when the angel went to Mary to say that she's going to have a baby. She was a young girl. She was between 12 and 15. I'm sure there were older virgins around that time, but God didn't go to them. She was a very young girl. And the angel told her that she's going to get pregnant and she will have a baby. And the baby's name will be what? Jesus. She was a young girl. God didn't say, no, I think she's too young. Let me look for an old mama. He used Mary. So let's read the text under the Virgin Mary. Luke 1:26. During Elizabeth's 6 month of pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to a virgin who lived in Nazareth, a town in Galilee. She was engaged to marry a man named Joseph from the family of David, Her name was Mary. God did not say Mary was too young. Mary was used, and she became the mother of our Savior, the whole Savior of the world. God used Mary. You see, God can use any of you in this room, any of you. Don't say that you are too young. He can appear to any of you and say, I'm going to use you. I want you to have a message. I want to send you. And God will give you the message and say, you have to deliver it. And you must deliver it. You can't keep it. So God might send you and say, go and tell Tina that she's doing this. She needs to stop. You need to come to me. I say, Auntie Tina, God told me yesterday to tell you this. You need to stop. And I will say, thank you. I say, God, forgive me. And I will stop. You can't say, oh, I can't tell Auntie Tina. If you don't tell me, and God's told you to tell me, and anything happens to me, God is going to hold you and say, I told you to go and tell her. You didn't tell her that this has happened. And God will hold you responsible. So you do have to give the message. Yeah, there are some people in the Bible, when God sends them to give the message, when they go to the king and they give the message, they run because the king will kill them. But they still give the message. But they go quickly and say, King, this is the message from God. And they run very, very fast. But they still give the message. They don't hide. Let's look at the next story. Josiah in the Bible. Josiah was a king in Israel. Let's read the text. 2 Kings 22, 1 to 2. What does it say?
Josiah,
8 years old when he became king. He ruled 31 years in Jerusalem. Josiah did what the Lord said was right. He did good things as his ancestor David had done. Josiah did not stop doing what was right. He was 8 when he became king, a whole king, 8 years old. And he sat on the throne, and people bowed before him, Your Majesty, 8. At that time in Israel, because people were worshiping idols, they would go to the forest, they would cut down the tree, they would carve the tree, they would make it into an image. You know, like you're building a snowman. They will put the eyes on the tree, they will put the nose, they will put the mouth, they will say, this is our God. Then they will start bowing down and say, this is our God. And God was angry. God said, I am the one who created the tree. How can you not say that the tree is your God? When I created the tree, you understand? So God was not happy. He said, you cannot worship anything. You can only worship me because I am God. So Josiah, even though he was 8, a little boy, he made a rule, a command. Nobody should worship idol again in Israel. You can only worship God. And he was a little boy. He did good when he was a king. There were some grown-ups who were kings, and even they made people worship idols. They would make an idol and tell everybody, worship, this is our God, worship. And Josiah, a little boy, he knew the right thing to do. That no. So you see, he wasn't too young. He was 8. How old are you?
5.
You see, in 3 years, then you are Queen of England. In 3 years, when you're 8. Yeah? And we'll be coming to you, Michelle. I'm bowing down. Queen Michelle. In only 3 years, 8. Yeah? That's how old Josiah was. And he was king. And he had grown-up men standing beside him here. You know, when the king sits down, there's always people standing next to him and they're fanning him. Yeah, grown-up people. And he's the king and he knew the right thing because whatever he says, that's an order. So if he told the people, just worship what you want, that's what they would do. But he said, no, we have to worship God. He wasn't too young. Let's look at Samuel. You all know Prophet Samuel,
no.
And you know his story.
No.
Let's, you don't know the story.
No.
His mom was called Hannah, and Hannah could not have a baby. So Hannah went to pray to God that she wants a baby. She said she wants a son. She didn't pray for a baby, she prayed for a son. And she said, God, if you give me a son, I will give him back to you. And then God answered her prayer. She got pregnant and she had a son and called him Samuel. And when Samuel was about maybe 5 years old, very young, she took him to the tabernacle, the temple, and he started living there with the priest Eli. Because, you know, she prayed that if you give me a son, I'll give him back to you. So he's now worshiping God in the temple. He's now there, living there. He's now a prophet. He's a little boy. Yeah? So you know the story now. Yeah? So what's Samuel's mom's name? I just said it.
Hannah.
Hannah. Thank you. You were listening. So let's read the text. Yeah, sorry.
This was in one of your Samuel, right?
Yeah. Yeah. In the book of Samuel. So that was the beginning, first Samuel. Yeah, so she, because her husband had two wives, had her and another wife, and the other woman had children, and she didn't have children. So her, the other wife, Peninnah, always used to taunt Hannah. And those days, they used to believe that if you didn't have a baby, you were wicked. You've done something wrong, so God is punishing you. That was the belief. So Peninnah used to taunt Hannah and say, you are evil, you are wicked, you've done something evil in your life. That's why God's not giving you a baby. So, but nowadays we don't think that. If somebody doesn't have a baby, we don't think that they've done anything evil. But that was the belief then. So Hannah kept on praying and said, God, just give me a son, you know, so that Peninnah can shut up. And God gave her. And she had other children after Samuel. You see, we don't even know Peninnah's children's names. But you see, we know Hannah and we know her son, Samuel, because he became a powerful prophet in Israel. So let's read the text under Samuel. 1 Samuel 3, 1 and 4. What does it say?
The boy Samuel
served the Lord under Eli. Then the Lord called Samuel.
Samuel answered,
I am here. Samuel was sleeping and Eli was also sleeping, and Samuel heard his name. Samuel, he heard his name. He got up and he ran to Eli. Here I am, you called me. Eli said, I didn't call you. Go back and sleep. He went back to sleep. He heard his name being called again. He got up, he ran to Eli. Here I am, you called me. Eli said, I didn't call you. Go back and sleep. And it happened again the third time. And then Eli thought, oh, God is calling him. Because, you know, he's a little boy. He doesn't understand. And then Eli said, if you hear the voice again, say, speak, Lord. Your servant listens. So you say that. So when Samuel heard his name again, he said, speak, Lord. Your servant listens. Then God started speaking to Samuel, telling him many things that will happen in Israel. Told him about Eli, because Eli's sons were wicked boys. So God was telling Samuel everything. I'm going to punish Eli. I'm going to punish his sons. You want to ask a question? Yeah.
The last time when I was getting to school, I heard my name twice.
You heard your name, and you didn't see who was calling you. Next time, say, speak, Lord. Michelle listens, and God will speak to you. Yeah? Maybe God was calling you, wanted to give you a message for Auntie Tina. And you see? So next time, say, speak, Lord. Michelle listens. Yeah? Yeah? Yeah. So maybe it was God calling you. So God told Samuel a lot of secrets. So in the morning, he was afraid to go and tell Eli. Eli called him and said, what did God tell you yesterday? He didn't want to say. And Eli said, you must tell me what God said. And then Samuel told him, God said that he's going to punish you and your sons because you're doing all wicked things. And Eli said, he's God. Let him do what seems right. And God did punish Eli and the family. You know, so Samuel became a great prophet. He was not too young for God to talk to him. You see, that's where I'm going. He was not too young. God can use anybody. The same way as you guys are not too young, I also, I am not too old for God to speak to me. Moses was like 80 when he led the children of Israel out of Egypt. He was 80 years. You know how old that is. But God used him. You know, Sarah, she was very old when she gave birth to Isaac. When she gave birth to the baby, she was old. But God still used her. So you're not too young and you're not too old. God can use you at any age. But it's better if God uses you when you are young. Because now you have strength. You see, you are young, you are strong. If me and Abel runs for the bus now, Abel will just get on it and stand there. I will almost keel over. I'll be like, I need a seat. I need to sit down. I'll be out of breath. You see, so it's better if God uses you when you are young and strong. You see, footballers, they don't stay very, very old before they retire because they cannot be running around. So I think in their 30s, they retire. You know, I don't know if a 50-year-old can be a footballer running around on the field, even though they're quite healthy and they do exercise, but they will be tired. They will get tired very, very easily. So you can't be too young. Don't let anybody shut you up and say you're a little kid. You can't do this or you can't do that. Yes, you can. God can use you at any age. Any questions? Any questions? Yeah.
I can do a cartwheel.
You can do cartwheel.
No, I can't.
You can't. Yeah, when you practice, you'll be able to do it. I can't do it.
I can even do a rolly poly.
You can't.
I can do a rolly-poly.
You can do a rolly poly. Yeah, you see, because you are young, but I can't do that. Any questions? No questions? Right, that's today's lesson. Thanks for listening.